Hello and happy Tuesday. This is our Tuesday morning leadership talk above on Team. And today we are going to talk about social media. I want to start with a quote, as I always do, and that quote is, if you do what you've always done, you'll always get what you've always gotten. And that's a quote by Tony Robbins. And it really ties into what we're going to talk about today. I've been following, I think you have probably seen by some of the things I've shared on our team page, I've been following a lot of what Danielle Natoni, Fit and Funky, has shared recently. And I came across one of her videos yesterday, and it was awesome. It was about her crave technique when it comes to social media. So she starts off by talking about forming a habit. So you want to start running. So what do? You put your shoes next to your bed so that when you see your shoes first thing in the morning, you know you need to get out of bed, you need to go for your run. Eventually you start running more, you start getting that runner's high, you feel so good that you don't even need your shoes to signal you anymore. It becomes a habit. It becomes something you crave. It becomes something you want to do, similar to us with our workouts in the morning. What we want to do is turn our social media pages into something that our followers crave. We want our followers to seek us out. The Facebook algorithms are really tough to beat right now. As you know, most of us have started a like page recently and we're seeing very few likes and small engagement. And that's because it's not getting out in the newsfeed, but we need to give people a reason to come and actually look for us. So she uses this acronym, CRAVE, to go over. C meaning content. So what are you providing? You want to be a resource for people. So instead of just posting a picture of you with your Shakeology cup and be like, drinking my shake today, can you share a recipe or share something about an ingredient in it that makes it so beneficial to us? Why do you drink it every day? Not just that you drink it every day. People know we drink it every day, but why do you do it? Not just sharing that you went grocery shopping, but sharing that maybe you bumped into one of your challengers who you haven't seen in a while, who had a 10-pound weight loss and just looks and feels so much better. Maybe a quote that person shared with you while you were out. Or sharing something new that you found at the grocery store. So be a resource to people. Give them a reason to come looking at your page. The R stands for reliability. So you have to show up every single day. 3 to 5 times a day, you've got to be posting it. And I don't want to say this in a mean way, like it doesn't matter what you're going through. I understand that we all have things that we're going through with our families, things that we might be sharing, things that we might be keeping to ourselves, things that are extremely difficult. But we need to still show up for our followers if we expect them to still be there for us. There are hundreds of thousands of health and fitness coaches out there. And as soon as we stop showing up, our followers are going to go seek somebody else out. I mean, it's just as true as that. And I say that too, because if you were to go to Starbucks at 3 o'clock on a Monday afternoon, expecting your favorite coffee that you get every Monday at 3 o'clock and they were closed, what would you do? You'd probably be upset and be less likely to go there next time. You'd go to a competitor because there are coffee shops on every corner around here. So just something to keep in mind, being reliable. This is also why I tell new coaches that if you are coming into this and you plan to grow this as a business, treat it like a business and be here in a year. Commit to being consistent for a year. If you go back through my page over the past 15 months, you can see there's not a day where I've posted less than 3 to 5 times, and I've always been there through the ups and downs, through losses, through weddings, through, I started when Brock was 5 months old, so I know what it's like to do it with a baby around, just going through a lot of it. So just remember to be reliable. Be there for your followers. The A stands for ask questions. So ask questions to your followers. Make them feel like they're helping. People love to feel like they're helping out. They love to feel like their opinion is valued and matters to you. Plus, it helps to boost engagement. Even if it's something like, and Danielle uses the example, and I laughed because I did see a few top coaches do this, but their elite pictures came out. They're like, which picture am I going to choose? You know, each and every one of those coaches knew exactly which picture they were going to choose. But they put it out there anyway, boosted engagement. Team logos, we do things like that. I'll do different outfits or shoes. Yeah, sometimes I am genuinely looking for some help because my fashion sense just is not there. But other times I'm already out the door before I posted the actual picture, before I got it up. So just something to keep in mind about boosting engagement, asking questions, you know, asking people to share their own pictures or comments. The V stands for value. So this really goes back to something that we've focused a little bit on, but could probably spend more time on. Do you know who your followers are and what content they are seeking from you? So sure, I could share a tutorial on how to change a tire, and it would be a great and valuable tutorial, but people in my target market aren't looking for that. They are looking for recipes for busy nights. They're looking for how to fit workouts in with a busy schedule. They might be looking for different exercises to work their core or motivational quotes to help push them forward. Things like that, that's what they're looking for. Fun ways to incorporate their baby into working out. So keep in mind who you are trying to talk to and adding value for what they need. Another example is to think of yourself before you started your journey with Beachbody and what you were looking for and what questions you might have had at that time. And then the E is engagement. So be there for your followers. Danielle shows that she carves out about 15 to 20 minutes after she puts a post up to respond to people who are commenting on her posts. Now, this is something that you might not need to do just yet, but as you get more followers and they're responding, it's really beneficial to be there to respond to them so that even if you need to take 3 hours off social media later and people comment in that time, they can see that you've already responded to a few, so they know that you're there. But just being there and being present for the people who are asking you questions or are commenting on your posts. So that is her crave technique. And I love the way she puts that in, and it can help you to keep in mind. So if you can't post throughout the day, or if nighttime seemed to be more difficult, focusing on scheduling posts that fit into that. Again, it's a little harder to get back to engaging with people after they comment on your post at that point, but when you can, be there for them. So I always like to have a little call to action. And today's call to action is to think of someone you follow on social media. What is it about his or her page that makes you want to come back for more? This can be a blog, it can be a Facebook page, a YouTube channel, etc. And it doesn't just have to be a Beachbody coach. So my example isn't even a Beachbody coach. It's actually somebody I started following. It's a blog I started following when I was like close to having Brock, and I just fell in love with her because she was about to have a baby boy at the same exact time. You know, while I was going through the struggles of nursing, I was watching her, following her, going through the same exact things. And I just loved, for me personally, I loved how real she was just sharing her story. She shared lots of good things about like fun snacks she would eat and her different fitness moves as she was recovering from having her baby. So I was really able to connect to her there and have not spent much time following the blog lately because I've been so focused on what I'm doing, but I'm now going to make it a point to go back to start looking at what she's sharing again to kind of generate some ideas in mind, see what it is that I could be missing sharing on my page. So what I'd like you to do is to go back to see what they're sharing and like at least their last five posts and look at what topics they're talking on and how you can incorporate things like that into your own language with your own pictures and recipes and workouts and everything into your social media. So I would love to hear from you guys next, but for those of you not on this call, you know, if you could leave in the comments below who you're following right now and what things they're sharing on and what attracts you to their pages. And then in the near future, I'd like to do something together where, you know, maybe we do a little bit of a profile review or something like that if you'd be up for it. So thank you so much for taking the time to listen.